talking point. I'm your host, Neeraj Shah. 2020 and 2021, while they will be remembered for COVID, from an Indian markets perspective, they'll also be remembered for or noted for the rise of many and the rise in the listing of many niche businesses, which do not necessarily have an industry unto themselves. They're charting their own course. One such space is what now has become fairly popular, popularly known as CPaaS. And I think the pioneer out there from an Indian perspective is Route Mobile. Various global competitors, but in Indian landscape, probably the only one. And after having what I would arguably say is a very interesting last 18 odd months, we thought it's best to get in the men at the helm of affairs at Route Mobile to try and understand how do they see 2022 shaping up for the industry and for them. Rajdeep Gupta, MD and founder of Route Mobile, as well as Gautam Badalia, the group CSO, joining. Gentlemen, both of you, thank you so much for joining in. Hope all is safe.
Good morning, Rich.
Good morning.
Yeah, good morning to both of you. Rajdeep, can I start off with you? It's been an eventful, I would say, last 12 months. There have been a quarter or two where you could argue that maybe they're not chinks in the armor, but really things didn't go quite as per anticipated. But I think you've resurrected the base. Things are looking fairly good. And you seem to be on an acquisition spree. Lay it out how 2021 was for you and how do you expect 2022 to be?
Yeah, I think, if you see 2021, and I think we are always growing quarter on quarter, you know, like, and I think that's a trajectory we see right now also. And quarter three is always the best quarter for Route Mobile, you know, from last so many years. And this quarter is also very important for us. And probably we are looking the same trajectory of growth this quarter as well. And in terms of customer acquisition, in terms of hiring new executive team, you know, like we have had lots of people in US, in Europe, in UK. We are still hiring lots of people in different markets right now, so market like Indonesia. So we believe that there are lots of opportunity in this space, and because of the tailwind which we have seen in past, I think this is definitely going to continue. And people have already adopted, the enterprises especially adopted the CPaaS, you know, like as a part of their engagement platform or services which they need. So we believe that we are in the right space, right time, and the potential of this whole space is going to grow multifold as people have predicted. And our prediction is the same.
Rajdeep, is the industry globally consolidating or is your spate of acquisitions, and I believe you've done multiple ones in the last 6 months, if I'm not wrong, is your spate of acquisitions exceptional?
I think the consolidation is a part of the CPaaS industry, you know, because larger players keep on growing larger, and I think the smaller player, they definitely partner who can be with them, and they can actually grow themselves along with a larger player. I think that's the whole idea of the CPaaS, because if there's a local player instead of say Indonesia, definitely has an aspiration to go global market, you know, like, but definitely he needs some partner like Route Mobile to grow himself to get into that market. I think the consolidation is definitely going to be there, and we all are going to see that this consolidation is going to continue. And as a company, we believe that whatever we have built and whatever our vision is we will definitely try to invest more on organic and inorganic in coming days.
Gautam, thanks for joining in. Your acquisition strategy clearly shows the appetite for the fueling of your international ambitions. Talk to us a bit about that.
So, Neeraj, thank you once again for having us here. First of all, I think what is happening today is CPaaS has increasingly become the backbone of enterprise communication, right? And most enterprises have accelerated their digital adoption. So from that perspective, at this point in time, because of this transition, it has kind of created a massive runway for growth. It's kind of a land grab opportunity at this point in time. And that is one precise reason why we see a lot of large players globally, including Route Mobile. I mean, we are one of the largest in emerging markets. We have been consolidating this space, getting into newer geographies, expanding the product line, so that we could offer the increased or the augmented bouquet of services to the clients wherever, I mean, we are servicing in various geographies at this point in time. So that's the two-pronged strategy that we are pursuing.
Gautam, would this necessarily be a string of pearls strategy from your end? And do you reckon, looking at the size of the market and the opportunity, that you would continue with this for the foreseeable future? And can you tell us a bit about the nature of the acquisitions that you look for, the sizes, the geographies, and for how long do you foresee that you would continue doing both the organic you would continue for life, but the inorganic way as well, so to say?
So good thing is, I think on the organic front, we are seeing massive growth that's kind of occurring to the company for the last 3 years. The last 3 years, growth CAGR has been about 41%. Last year, we grew at 47% YOY basis. So organic front, I think we are doing well. And as I said, I mean, it's a land grab opportunity. So we continue to kind of enter into newer geographies. We have identified LATAM as a key market. We have pursued an acquisition in LATAM. We have acquired a company called Massivian, which is kind of a leader in Colombia, having deep enterprise penetration there. So we're going to use Massivian as a beachhead to springboard into some of the adjoining markets. Likewise, so definitely, I mean, so even when we went IPO, I mean, we were generating a lot of free cash. There was no particular reason to go IPO at that point in time. The only reason why we wanted to kind of pursue the public markets listing was to have currency for acquisition. We wanted to consolidate, and looking at what players from the West, I mean, they're looking at consolidating, becoming big. We wanted to pursue a similar strategy where because of the kind of work that we have done over the last 17 years, we don't want to lose out on an opportunity, I mean, which is up there for grab for the next 3-5 years. We see a 20-25% growth for the industry. And considering we are a formidable player in this ecosystem, we would definitely want to grow at a rate faster than the industry growth rate.
Rajdeep, would there be a need, I mean, considering that both of you are saying that the opportunity size is so high, and I'm trying to focus a lot more on what would happen in 2022, but would you reckon there could be a further need for any kind of fundraising because the opportunity size is so large, or would the QIP plus the internal cash flows do the trick for you for 2022 at least?
As of now, we have already 1100 crores on our books right now. And so I always believe that, you know, there's an opportunity which is going to create more value for Route Mobile. And if we require to raise fund, we will definitely not shy away with that. And we will definitely raise fund to acquire a larger asset. It all depends on what asset we are buying and what asset is going to create what kind of value for the Route Mobile. So we are happy to do that in future also. And if required, we will definitely do that.
Okay. Rajdeep, let me change the tact of my question. You would remember, maybe you would remember, but when you came out with the IPO and when we were talking at that point of time, for a lot of people who didn't quite understand this industry very well, maybe we still don't do as well, obviously. It seemed to be that Root has a larger, not a one-trick pony, but a majority of the revenues coming in. The diversification of product offerings, while was happening, could it be done differently, etc.? Maybe the market anticipated you do it differently, what have you. My question to you is this: going ahead with the mix that you have currently and the geographical mix that you have, do you reckon that you would want to diversify the product offerings even more, go into depth into some of the other offerings as well? Or do you believe the current mix is good enough for you and the right mix for you for growth for the next few years?
So I think right now, Neeraj, whatever we are building or whatever we have built, you know, like, I think that is enough for next 2 to 3 years down the line. But there is definitely one area which I want to focus is blockchain. And we as a company, we already started working on blockchain from last 6 months. And I think there is another area which is called a big data analytics. So we are launching some product on big data analytics very soon. You know, like, India is definitely struggling on DLT in a big way. You know, like, it's a big hype has been created, DLT. But there was a post by myself, you know, like, I just try to highlight how much revenue operators are losing. I still say the 100 crore revenue per annum or some of the operators are losing. That needs a big data analytics tool, which they need to verify what kind of leakages are happening on their network. This is very critical. It is not just India. It is going to be all across the globe. The platform or the product which we want to launch on big data analytics is to make sure to understand the leakages on the domestic traffic. Most of the operators right now, they are focusing only on the international traffic or coming to their network. And they say that is the only leakages they are having. But the biggest culprit is the domestic traffic. Most of the operators, they don't actually focus on the domestic traffic. And most of the domestic traffic is creating lots of mess for the operator, and they're losing big way. Putting a DLT platform, blockchain is a great technology to have this kind of a platform. But implementing blockchain-based DLT solution is something what operator really needs to take care of themselves. And I literally say that India is struggling in a big way as of today. And right now, our focus is to build something on the big data analytics and blockchain. In coming years down the line, this is what our focus is going to be. But RCS, WhatsApp for Business, you know, we recently launched a product called as Click to Pay. I think these are the some products which is already built in-house. And we believe that this adoption ratio of these products are still not reached to the maximum level. You know, like it is just getting adopted by most of the enterprise customers, which will take another 2 to 3 years for an enterprise to adopt almost multiple channel of communication. And like still the SMS is the king. You know, most of the transaction which we see is happening over SMS. So whatever we have built is already has a future product, which may take another 2 to 3 years for a digital maybe adoption ratio. But at the same time, as a tech founder, we believe that there are certain areas where CPaaS operators especially require lots of big data analytics tools to analyze their data, especially for leakages, and we would love to work on that case.
Yeah, I think you put out a tweet to that effect a few days back, if I'm not wrong. I'd seen that. Just quick follow-up out there, Rajdeep, before I ask Gautam about the other strategies too. But a quick follow-up, I heard you mention that there is a vacuum wherein nobody else is quite doing this pre-data analytics in India, and it would be a good clinch for the operators to get it. Would this market be, restricted to the operators, or do you reckon that the PDL can actually expand to multiple other corporates and they could benefit, or because of the nature of your business, it'll be restricted to the telecom operators, so to say?
Not exactly. I think there are certain data analytics we can provide to multiple banks also, you know, like various other customers. They can use our platform and to see there are lots of data crunching is required for almost every enterprise customer, you know, like how their spend is being. What is ROI? If somebody wants to calculate the ROI, they need some kind of dashboard or some kind of...
This would be happening here, Rajdeep. I mean, I hear corporation after corporation talking about data analytics in a big way. So that's my point, really.
So right now, I think what we are building is for operator. That's a major point where we believe that... we have already proved that there is a lots of leakages happening all across the globe. In fact, you can say that. India is a big vulnerable market as of today. And if operators are really serious to... make sure that they have a concern to make more money. If they're losing money on voice, they can do something on the DLT kind of platform where that they can make more money. And I think we are here to help them to make more money.
So when does this hypothetically get launched?
We are targeting month of January. You know, that's a target. Okay. We've already got most of the stuff done. It's a product launch. We want to launch along with 365 Squared. And I think it's an interesting product. We will definitely have insight, you know, like, and we believe that operator will make more money with this product.
And all the best. Who doesn't like making more money, Rajdeep? I'm sure.
I think my point out there is, Neeraj, I want operator to be more, you know, like, they need to be vigilant. You know, that's my point. You know, and if somebody's coming in front that, okay, I want you to make money, I think they should accept it.
Inshallah, as they say. Okay, again, changing tact a bit, and Gautam, I would want you to come in. When I was reading a couple of reports which made this point that almost all the acquisitions that you guys have done in the recent past have a higher margin profile than what the conglomerate or the consolidated Route Mobile currently has. Is this an active consideration while you're going for your acquisitions, or not necessarily? And part two of my question is, with that being said, when these efficiencies come to the fore and operational leverage comes to the fore, do you reckon console operational metrics of Route Mobile over the course of the next 2 years, by virtue of operating leverage and acquisitions which you've already done or will do, will be higher than what they are right now?
Sure. So, yeah, definitely. I mean, whenever we look at or evaluate any acquisition target, review it from the perspective of whether it's accretive or dilutive. More often than not, only if it is, I mean, to kind of expand the product line where there is kind of a dire need of a critical part or component of the product, there we would not kind of look at an accretive or dilutive considerations. But besides that, I mean, most acquisitions that we kind of evaluate as part of our litmus test, I mean, the acquisition ought to be accretive, and that is one primary consideration that we look at. And with some of these acquisitions now kind of we are able to kind of synergize, integrate a lot of technology aspects, build in a robust linear sort of a team across products. So that definitely will kind of over a period of time show up in terms of expansion of EBITDA margins.
The second last question to you, Gautam, and then a final word from Rajdeep. But to you, as you look at 2021 coming to a close and 2022, what are the couple of key things that you are looking forward to when it comes to Route Mobiles? I mean, and Rajdeep spoke about a near-term product launch that he's very keenly looking forward to for the year as a whole. From your end, Gautam, what is it that you're looking forward to do? What is it that you can expect from Route Mobile?
So a couple of things. First of all, I think Rajdeep alluded to the fact of the strong industry tailwinds. I mean, we definitely tend to benefit from the strong industry tailwinds. I think at the beginning of the year, we had given a guidance of 20-25%. I mean, we wanted to be more conservative because of the pandemic situation. Though, we are still at a fix when it comes to Omicron at this point in time. But looking at the run rate the business is clocking, I think we are reasonably confident of achieving a 30% plus growth for this year. That is again, a function of all the core products, now kind of clocking significant growth rates. While SMS continues to grow at a 20-25% growth rate, the newer channels of communications, which are significantly higher margin products, the growth rates are significantly faster. We're growing anywhere northwards of 50-60% at this point in time. I don't know if you've been tracking us of late. We have also started to realize that the startup ecosystem in India has become more and more thriving. There are a lot of developers now looking at kind of an open architecture where they can come pick up the APIs and start playing around with the APIs for creating their app or web ecosystem. So in a way, through Rapid, Rapid is Route Mobile API development program. We are trying to democratize the use of API applications, making it more and more seamless for the developers. So these are off-the-shelf APIs, which a developer can come. They can choose, pay through a credit card. They can take a $10, $20 credit. They can just pay it through their credit card and start consuming the services. We just consummated a hackathon where we had over 7,000 odd developers participating. And it was kind of a riveting experience for us. We wanted to make it an annual exercise, but looking at the kind of reception that we have received, we believe India is at the cusp of a Silicon Valley, a keen developer ecosystem. And that is where players like Route Mobile will become the backbone, as I said, for all such developer ecosystem products.
Anything to get that going, and certainly the startup ecosystem is thriving so hard that all of this would be welcome. Thanks for giving us those insights, Gautam. Rajdeep, a final business end question. I heard you guys though anyway speak about it, that you see a 20-25% CAGR growth opportunity for the next 3 to 5 years. Are you on track for a 25% performance this year? And if indeed that growth opportunity stays for the industry, I reckon Route Mobile could outperform. So talk a bit about that. And if indeed the operational metrics are going to expand from where they are right now, I would reckon that the profitability growth would be even more than what the CAGR top line growth could be for you. Can you talk a bit about that, Preston?
Yes, sure, Neeraj. If you see, I think as Gautam mentioned, we have already given a increase our guidance to over 30% growth this financial year. You know, and we believe that this is going to continue for next 2 to 3 years, and that's what we believe. Because the market is growing big, and there are certain geographies like Colombia or Latin America where we believe the margins are much higher. You know, like I think 40-45% margin we may go there. So I think we as a company are definitely going to focus more on profitability and gross margin. And that is one of the key areas. The reason we are developing more products, we're launching new products and working on WhatsApp or RCS, email kind of business. They all are more than 30 to 40% margin product line, you know. And in coming days, I think the adoption of these new channel of communication is going to be adopted more. And we will see more traction happening on these kind of channels, which means that more amount of revenue coming from this channel, which may lead to higher margin for Route Mobile.
Yeah. Okay. Well, gentlemen, both of you, thank you so much. Congratulations on a great 2021 and all the best for not just 2022, but the years ahead. Much appreciate your time.
Thanks, Neeraj. Thank you.
Thank you, Neeraj. Thank you.